You own a birth certificate, a national insurance card, driver's license, and more than likely a passport, all of which you should always keep properly secured. You see, if any one of those things are misplaced or stolen, more than likely you may become a victim of identity theft.
Identity theft is when criminals obtain your personal information and identity, which they will then use to open bank accounts, obtain loans, credit card, and obtain documents such as passport and driver's license.
Woman Detective Sergeant 2329 Debra Thompson of the Commercial Crimes Unit of the Royal Bahamas Police Force went on to further explain that there are two different types of identity theft.
With that information, they are able to commit what is called identity fraud. That is where they use that information to obtain goods and services by means of deception. And an example of that is if a person reports their passport lost or stolen, what we have seen in the past is that not so long after that passport is reported stolen, you would see that document was used to cash checks, counterfeit or fraudulent checks. And what they are doing is they are photo substituting those passports. That's a form of identity theft. Also, we are seeing a trend in relations to individuals applying for passports under the name of somebody else.
Question is the crime becoming more popular among would-be criminals?
Which I won't say it's popular, but it's something new that is developing, and we want to put a stop to it before it develops and or blows into something much bigger.
So what should you do if you feel as if you're a victim of identity theft?
First of all, if you've lost or your passport is lost or stolen, you ought to right away immediately report that to the nearest police station. If you feel that somebody has taken or stolen your identity, you need to come into the police department and report that. And the entities affected, you need to advise them as well. What we want to encourage the public is to safeguard their personal documentations, such as passport, driver's license. If you're not using them, you need to lock them up in a safe or a cabinet at home. Store your credit card, ATM cards, bank cards in a safe place. You don't need to carry them around with you. If there's not a need to carry them, but you need to safeguard them as well.
Now, as for the penalties, here's what you should keep in mind.
If a person is caught committing the offense of identity fraud, they can get up to a 5 years prison time if convicted.
So until next week, I'm Sasha Lightborn, and now you know you're right.